Good morning. May I request everybody to stand, please? Everybody to stand. Arms sideward. Forward. I know you just had your lunch, so we're going to do a little exercise. That's 10 counts. Sideward and then clap. Sideward, clap. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, take your seat. Thank you very much. I have a confession to make. This is the first time in all my speaking careers that the audience gave me a standing ovation even before I started speaking. Thank you very much. That's Luwalhati, the symbol of the University of the East. I am at present the Dean of the College of Education. I retired from the University of the Philippines. I retired from the University of the Philippines 10 years ago. So you will probably see that's my title. That's my favorite title. Mrs., I would rather be called Mrs. than doctor or professor. Only my students at UP, I'm not teaching at UE. Only my students at UP call me doctor or professor, but my colleagues call me Mrs. I tell them, I prefer to be called Mrs. than doctor or professor, because I had a more difficult time earning the Mrs. It was easier for me to get doctorate degree and professor in UP, because I was a faculty member, studying was free. So before I knew it, I had a doctoral degree. Professor, you just continue teaching, and every time there's a promotion, you get promoted. Professor ka na. But the Mrs., oh my God, it was really very difficult. I had to think very well. After graduation from my bachelor's degree, I didn't have a boyfriend yet because I promised my mother we would not get married until after 25. 25? 25. I said, where are the boys? Wala nang lumiligaw sa akin, 25. Where are the boys? Aha! The Boy Scouts of the Philippines. So I joined the Boy Scouts of the Philippines. And I was successful. I was successful because I coupled it with novena, continuous novena to St. Jude Thaddeus, the saint of desperate cases. Okay, teka pala, meron pala akong topic, sorry. My topic is on differentiated instruction. That's how I got here. Anyway, okay, so I'm going to differentiated instruction now. Oh, before I do that, I would like to recognize two of my friends who are here, my colleagues at who are members also of the Network of Outstanding Teachers and Educators. If you are awarded in Metrobank, you become a member of Noted. And we have two members of Noted here, I know. Miss Galicia, Meilani Galicia. Meilani celebrated her birthday yesterday. And she was so happy because she didn't need to send you invitations, you're here. And she was so happy because there was free food and accommodation for all her guests. Meilani, happy birthday. And also, Noel Ibis, where's Noel? Where's Noel? Oh, there's Noel. Noel won the Metrobank last year. Last year. Okay, thank you. So let me go to differentiated instruction. Acknowledgement. The PowerPoint presentation was prepared by for the Department of Education by me. I have put this because I had a two very bad experiences about PowerPoint presentation. You don't need to take pictures of this because this will be given to you. All the presentations here will be put in a CD and it will be given to you. And I had two bad experiences. One, when you had your grade 7 training, I was videoed with the health education, giving the health education orientation. And then in the University of the East, which is a center of training, when I watched the instructor, the trainers doing the training, of course, they changed my name in the dito sa umpisa. The instructor changed my name, removed this, and put her name. I felt bad about that. I felt bad. Sabi ko, because I was the one who did it, did the PowerPoint presentation, so that's why I'm putting this. I know, and it's okay for you to remove the first slide. Put your name because you're going to present it. But please acknowledge. And the other bad experience I had when I was judging the foundation test, contest, with Dr., one of my colleagues at the University of the Philippines, she saw in one of the documents her PowerPoint presentation and the name of the candidate. And she said, this is my PowerPoint presentation. Why did she put her name there and submitted it as a document? Right away, she was disqualified because that's dishonesty. So at least acknowledge. But hindi ba mahirap naman gawin? Hindi naman mahirap gawin yun, ano? Okay. Objectives of this session, I forgot to change this. It should be performance indicator. It should be performance indicator because I was oriented only yesterday about changes in the terminologies. There are three for this, which they have given me. At the end of the session, the participant will be able to discuss the basic principles of DI. Why did I highlight will? Why did I highlight will? Because teachers use different terminologies. Will, should be able to, are expected to, must. Okay. The accepted verb is will. Will, according to the one who revised Bloom's taxonomy, my senior memory is working. Who was the one who revised Bloom's taxonomy? Anderson and Prattwohl, thank you. Anderson and Prattwohl, will. And then the other two who did another taxonomy, which they called the new taxonomy, Marzano and Kendall. Marzano and Kendall also said will. Okay, English teachers, what's the difference between will and should and must? What's the difference? Will and should. Which is more likely to be accomplished at the end of the lesson? Will or should? Will. Should, it's yes, and it seems as if there's somebody telling you to do it. You should be able to do this. Okay, that's why it's will. So please take note of that. In CHED, we are also using will. Okay. So that's the first one. Discuss the basic principles of differentiated instruction. Sorry, DI is not dance instructor. That's differentiated instruction. The second one, identify activities suited to each component of DI, content, process, product, and environment, and identify activities that respond to learners' needs, readiness, interest, learning profile. I hope you will listen very well because you're going to repeat this in the seminar workshop in Baguio and Cebu. So these are the three. These are the three. And we will go back to this at the end of the session to find out if you have attained these three performance indicators. Okay, differentiated instruction is also called flexible instruction responsive to learners. It's also called responsive instruction, flexible instruction. So, and differentiated instruction. From these three words, you already have an inkling of what differentiated instruction is. Okay. This is a very activity-oriented session. The activity, I'm following the four A's. The first activity is called true or false. The first thing we will do is choose your team leader and recorder, and then I'll show you some pictures, and they give you clues about differentiated instruction. Okay, we're going to choose our, are you seated by learning areas? Mathematics, where's math? Science, English, Filipino, TLE, wala na bang TLE sa inyo? Ay, grade 10, values education, MAPE, that's my area, MAPE. Ano pa hindi ko natawag? Filipino. Did I call Pil? Ayun, Filipino. Meron ako hindi natawag? Araling Panlipunan. Ayun, ay. Okay, please occupy at least, bring together all the members of your group because you're going to work as a group, as a learning area. Can you just please, I'm sorry, I thought you're already seated by learning areas. Just be together. So we have 7 learning areas. Just put your tables together, near each other. We're going to choose our team leader and recorder. All right. Right hand up, please. Right hand up. With the pointer like that. When I say go, point to the team leader, point to the person whom you would like to be team leader. The highest will be the team leader. Ready? Go! The highest will be the team leader. Okay. We have a team leader. Left hand up, pointer, point to the recorder who you will choose. Ready? And go! Recorder. Okay. Can we request the team leader and the recorder of each group to please stand? Team leader, recorder, sit beside each other. Sit beside each other so you can take down notes. Please remain standing. Team leader and recorder, do we have here? Please stand. Stay closer together. This group, team leader, recorder, the middle group. Okay, hold hands please, so that I know you are near each other. Hold hands. Uy, naku, may nangyayari ba dyan? Alright, wala naman. I now pronounce you team leader and recorder. Let's clap our hands for them. Thank you. Okay. Analyze, I'm going to show you some pictures about the differentiated instruction. Analyze the picture, and then afterwards, I will give you the true or false test. The picture will give you an idea of whether to answer true or false. Ready? Next. This is the seating arrangement. That's the blackboard, the whiteboard. The teacher's table is here. Okay. If you are If you are lucky enough to be different, about don't ever change. All right. Tell whether the statement is true or false. I'll give you 1 minute to discuss among yourselves. You should have only one answer. And then I will ask you for another minute to say the reason why your answer is like that. Why is your answer true or why is your answer false? And at signal, after 2 minutes, those who answer true will stand, those who answer false will remain seated for each item. Okay, ready? You have to discuss because you should have only one answer. 2 minutes. Ano po? Makita niyo ulit? Wala na pong ulitan. Okay, ready? First statement. Differentiated instruction is individualization. 1 minute. 1 minute for your answer. Give your reason why. Why? Time's up. Time's up. I forgot another one. When I say time's up, please repeat. Okay. Time's up?
Time's up.
Good. Time's up?
Time's up.
All right. Now I know you're ready. Whose answer is true? Please stand. True. Individualization. Your answer is false, right? False. All right. So we have almost everybody answered true. Excuse me, bakit kayo may nakaupo, may nakatayo? The correct answer is false. This group has it. 1.4, what's your group? 1.4 ESP. All right. Why? Why?
We are for differentiated instruction. We are for individual differences of respecting each of the learner, but we do not make them. We do not separate them. We do not quarantine. We do not box them for their individuality. But we do not isolate each the learner from the other learners.
Okay. How would the class manage if you are doing individualized instruction and you have 45, is that the regular number of the class in public schools, 50 students in your class, and you're teaching also other subjects with 50, how will you manage individualization with that? That's very impractical. And, okay, let's see. There is something that is done by the DI, something done by DI, which is not individualization. All right. Talk among yourselves. How are you different from the other members of your group? How are you different from the other members of your group? Okay? Sige. Among yourselves. How are you different? Can I have one answer? Can I have one answer?
Ma'am, the interest at saka expertise. Opo. Kakaiba po kami, ang aking pagkakaiba sa kanila, ay ako po ay lecturer, then writer sa Pilipino at nagdi-deliver. Sila naman magaling.
O sige. Siya? Sir, ano pa pangalan? Okay, si Sir Edwin, lecturer, writer at nagdi-deliver. So, yun ang kaibahan niya sa kanila. All right. Can I ask all of you, how many of you are also like Edwin, lecturer, writer, and ay lecturer at writer the same sa deliver, unless delivery boy kayo na noon. Hindi. Ano po? Writer and lecturer. Okay. Sino po sa inyo ang writer and lecturer din? Writer and lecturer. Can you please stand those who are writers and lecturers like Edwin? Okay. Dito, writers and lecturers at the same time. Please stand. Please remain standing. Please remain standing. I want to see. Okay. So, can you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Nakatayo po kayo. 15. So, you are not really different. Very different. You are not only one. You have other 15 others who are with you. So, what do we call that? We don't target individual students in the class, but what we do is we cluster them. That's clustering. We put them together because they have similar differences, you know, similar differences, so we cluster them. We don't attack them individually. Okay, next, number two. Stand and deliver by the teacher. Mabilis naman kayo, so I'll just give you for the answer. Okay, reason, right, give you reason. Okay, time's up. Time's up. Uy, nakalimutan. Time's up. Time's up. All right. Whose answer is true? Please stand. True. True. Uy, nobody. No. True. Answer is true. One, two. No more? The correct answer is false. 2 points. 1, 1, 1, 1. All right. Why? Stand and deliver is the teacher. Actually, stand and deliver is the speech, the title of the program on television for outstanding teachers in the United States. They stand and deliver their talk. Okay. Reason. Why is that false?
Batay po doon sa amin na pag-usapan, kaya po false. Sa tingin po nila, hindi lahat ng pagkakataon nasa teacher. Teacher-centered po yung nakita. So we have to ask our student regarding sa lessons or learning.
Thank you very much. That's a good answer. Is there any addition to the answer of Filipino from the other groups who said false? Any addition to that? Okay, they hit the word. It's not teacher-centered. It's not teacher-centered. But it does not mean that the teacher is already irrelevant. I'll explain that later. Next is covering the content. Differentiated instruction is covering the content. Go. Time's up. Naku, again, time's up. Time's up. Time's up. Okay. True. True. Those who answered true, please stand. Those who answered true, false, remain seated. Nobody answered true? The answer is false. So everybody gets 1 point. Everybody gets 1 point. Why? Why is DI not covering the content? What's your reason? Science?
Because you are addressing, as a teacher, you are addressing the needs of your learners and their specific interests as you recluster them more than the content itself.
Correct answer. Any addition from the other groups? Yes, ma'am. From MAPE?
Good morning. Whenever we teach, it does not necessarily mean that we have to cover all the contents in one teaching. Because when we teach the concepts and the sub-concepts, we always relate this with so many things. For example, we base this from human experiences. We link this with other factors other than the content itself.
Thank you. You got it. It's not the content that's really important. We don't cover the content. Otherwise, you want to say something?
Good morning. In addition po, teachers should, in DI, we meet where the learners are. And the moment we tend to cover the content, the likelihood of having learners who are left behind because of our intention to cover or to cover the ground of the competencies expected of us to teach is more likely to happen. So in DI, we meet where the learners are.
And the tendency, okay, correct answer. And the tendency is for you to hurry up if you are very content-oriented. If you have not covered it and it's almost the end of the school year, you tend to hurry up. All right, so that's correct. Let's see number four. Differentiated instruction is related to competencies. Go. Okay. Time's up. Time's up. Time's up. All right. True? Stand. True? Everybody, nobody sitting down? Okay, oh, you're all correct. You're all correct. Why is it related to competencies? Why is differentiated instruction related to competencies? What's the reason that you discussed?
We do believe that our competencies is non-negotiable, and using the competencies, we will reach what we want to attain in the future.
Helen hit it right on the head. It is non-negotiable. Competencies are non-negotiable. All right. We don't differentiate competencies. It's related to competencies. Next, number five. It is learner-centered. Learner-centered. Naku, sinasabi na niyo sagot, ha? You're very sure, ha? And then, why? Why? Time's up? Time's up? All right. True? Stand? False? Sit down. Remain seated. True? Oh my, wonderful. The answer is true. 1 point for everybody. One point for everybody. And differentiated instruction is MOTS, more of the same. More of the same. More of the same. Time's up? Time's up? Naku, walang sumasagot. Time's up? You're still discussing? Time's up? Time's up? All right. True? Stand? False? The correct answer is false. False. You're all correct. You're all correct. Why? Why? What is your reason? What is your reason? Can I call on this group? Reason? Why? Why is DI not more of the same?
Good morning, everyone. We believe that in differentiated instruction, teachers need to be creative and to stimulate critical thinking. So we cannot just dwell on those traditional ways of teaching. Thank you.
Okay. Variety is the spice of life. All right. Next. Depends on learner needs. I have a suspicion. Whose answer is true? True for this one. Depends on learner needs. Can you stand those whose answer is true? 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 Oh, tama. Oh, sige. Correct. Depends on learner needs. Because I heard you give that reason already. I heard you give that reason. So I will not ask for the reason anymore. And this is the last. Clustering for multiple needs. I already gave the clue. Not individualization, but clustering. Okay? So bonus yan. Bonus. That's true. Bonus. Who is the winner? Which group is the winner? Ilang kayong points? Perfect. 8 points. Wow. Anybody else got 8 points? Wala, sila lang. Okay, will you please stand? Stand. Tap yourself on the shoulder. Tap yourself on the... Ang galing namin. Gagaling namin. Thank you. Okay. After that exercise, what did you learn about differentiated instruction? What did you learn about differentiated instruction? Combine the item in the true or false and your reason. Combine the item in the true or false and your reason. Just get one item and your reason. Put them together. Can I give you 1 minute to think about that? Okay. You can start your sentence with differentiated instruction is ta-ta-ta because ta-ta-ta. Can we have one answer from each learning area? Let's start with our champion. Edukasyon sa pagpapakatao.
For us, differentiated instruction is catering to the learner's needs and interests, including their talents, abilities, and skills using varied instructions.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mary. Yes. Put together the what and the why. Filipino.
Good morning, everyone. Differentiated instruction is a mechanism to sustain the individual needs of the students considering their indifferences for us to assess or to give instruction better for them. That's why we have the differentiated instruction, to strategize so that learning will be more fun and so that no students will be left behind.
Wow, isn't that wonderful? Very good, thank you, thank you. MAPE.
Ito po ang sagot ng MAPE. What did you learn about DI? It is not a one-size-fits-all because every individual has unique needs.
Thank you. Dinagdagan niyo pa. All right. And another group? Can we have that group there? Science? Okay. Thank you. Learner-centered. Which group has that given their idea yet? Yes, all right. Go, go.
Differentiated instruction is not about making individual activities, but you can have clustering in order for you to address every student's needs.
Roger. Roger, that's my dead husband's name. Your namesake, Roger. Naalala ko tuloy. Kasi, kaya lang mas gwapo siya sa'yo. Okay, sige.
In differentiated instruction, one size doesn't fit all, which means variety of activities should be given to our learners. It is also learner-centered, wherein pupils are engaged in their own learning. That is tantamount to saying, learning, applying the principle of learning by doing.
I don't think, asan si Sol, si Ma'am Sol? Naku, Ma'am Sol, mukhang hindi na ako kailangan dito. Ang gagaling nila, ang gagaling nila. Alam na nila. Anybody else? Have we called all the members, all the groups? Natawag na lahat? Oh, sige, let's... Did I call you already? Hindi pa yata. You are banking on my senior memory, ha?
For me, differentiated instruction is trying to know the level of each group of students and prepare materials, approaches according to their level. They could be beginning, they could be at the average, or they could be the intelligent ones.
Another addition. Sige. I think when you go and train the teachers on DI, you will have a richer reservoir of activities and concepts on DI. Let's go. For a bit of history, how did DI start? In 1985, Differential, that was the original name, Differential Education for Gifted and Talented was coined by Virgil Ward of University of Virginia. They were very strong on special education for the gifted, so this was coined by Virgil Ward. And then in 1995, 10 years after Virgil Ward coined differential education, Carol Ann Tomlinson called it differentiated instruction. She's also from the University of Virginia, and she made it popular because she wrote a book on differentiated instruction, and she co-authored a book on differentiated instruction when Understanding by Design was very popular. So she partnered with an Understanding by Design author and she wrote a book on differentiated instruction. And most of what is in my lecture is coming from Tomlinson's book. Tomlinson, Carol Ann Tomlinson's book on differentiated instruction. Okay. This is the theoretical basis of differentiated instruction. Vygotsky, Lev Vygotsky, if you will remember your educational psychology, in 1896 to 1934, he mentioned zone of proximal development and scaffolding. Those are two concepts that Vygotsky champion, zone of proximal development, where there is a time when we reach our proximal development, maximum development in terms of mental. And when we have identified the development of the student, we should give the student something, one a little bit higher, more higher activities, so that the student will be challenged. Because if you do that, challenge is the word. If you give a student something very low, then they will be bored. They will be bored. Scaffolding is the assistance to be given by the teacher. There comes a time when a student is challenged, he or she might need to scaffold. You know the scaffolding, yung dinada, no, yung, what is that? Where the carpenters, where the painters, yun, they are assisted. That's the scaffold, and that's scaffolding by Lev Vygotsky. Well, you know Jerome Bruner, Interest and Organization of Learning. He did theories on that. And Howard Gardner, I'm sure everybody knows Howard Gardner of multiple intelligences. And this one is very important for you, for all of you. Honey and Mumford in 1982, they did learning styles. Honey and Mumford prepared a questionnaire, an 80-item questionnaire that identified the learning styles of students and of adults. And you will meet this pair again towards the latter part. It will be a surprise to you. Meyer, Briggs, another one, Dunn and Dunn, etc., they also did learning style. Dunn and Dunn did it according to environment. There are students who prefer a quiet environment to study. There are students who can study even when there is music. There are students who can do better if the chair is formal. There are students who do better if the chair is informal. Sitting on a sofa, sitting on the floor, other environmental factors. That's the one by Dunn and Dunn. There are many other authors who did learning styles. I just enumerated three of them. Okay. What is differentiated instruction? This is the definition of Tomlinson, Anne Tomlinson. It is a teacher's response. It is the response of the teacher to variations in learner's readiness, interests, and learning profile. The learning profile here is the learning style, multiple intelligences, etc. By making adaptations in content, process, product, and environment through varied teaching and management strategies. This is Allen and Tomlinson in 2000, and then De Gea wrote another one in 2004. Okay. We will meet these words again. We differentiate. We make adaptations in content. We discuss that. In the process, in product, and in the environment. And this management refers to environment, classroom management to environment. Okay. Your learning plan. Here, you have learning competencies. I don't know if, content, activities or the process, resources, and assessment or the product. The content is the same, no? As in the meaning, as in the definition. The learning competencies is here. The process are the activities. The process is the activities. The resources are the materials. I don't know if you still put this in your, I don't think you still put them in your learning plan. And then the assessment is the products. So you can differentiate every aspect except for which one will you not differentiate? Competencies. This is the one that's non-negotiable. You can differentiate all of the others. I want to relate this to the Philippine situation. DI. Because I just got that. Alam nyo, when I arrived yesterday, I had a complete presentation already. But every time I would talk to Saul, she would tell me things and then I have to add it there. So this one, I got it from an OBE presentation, outcomes-based education, because I'm a member of the CHED Task Force on Outcomes-Based Education. So sorry about that. I didn't have time to change it. Let's say DI in the Philippines Qualifications Framework. The Philippine Qualifications Framework is a national policy that establishes national standards and levels for outcomes of education and training, specializations, skills, and competencies. Director Joyce Andaya just came from Vietnam to represent the Philippines in the ASEAN Qualifications Framework. The chair of the Philippines Qualifications Framework, the appointed chair was Secretary Luisto, but I don't think she has time to sit there. So it's really Yusek Mateo who's sitting there. ASEC Mateo. What do we mean by qualifications framework? We are standardizing the qualifications, of our professionals so that now, 2015, diba? ASEAN 2015, now we are already borderless with our ASEAN countries, but they have not finished doing the ASEAN framework. What does it mean? If you want to teach in Indonesia, or in Singapore, and there is already that ASEAN qualifications framework, they will know where to put you, where to classify you based on your qualifications. So it will be a standardization of qualifications in all ASEAN countries. And Dr. Joyce was in Vietnam because they're still crafting the ASEAN qualifications framework. Now, why did I emphasize standards, outcomes, and competencies? Because in your learning plan, on top, you identify standards. And then you identified competencies. Competencies, standards. And in your assessment, you have learning outcomes. Ano ba kaiba ng tatlo? Pare-pareho ba sila? Anong pagkakaiba nila? Ngayon lang walang nagtaas ng kamay. Ngayon lang walang nagtaas ng kamay. Okay. So, are they similar? Are they the same? Let's see. I'm sorry, ito pa rin yun. It's the PQF, the Philippine, is in Executive Order Number 83, Series of 2012, signed by President Aquino. It's the institutionalization of the Philippine Qualifications Framework, institutionalized. Oh my God! Sorry about this. Kanina kasi nilipat yan. Competency-based education. What is the meaning of competency-based? It was developed in 1976. I'm sorry about this, ha? Kanina lang namin inilipat dahil kaninang umaga lang nabanggit sa akin ni Ms. Sol Reyes na kanina ko lang nakita yung inyong nakita ko dun sa learning plan niyo, merong competency, may standard, merong outcomes. So baka malito sila. Okay. This is competency-based. In 1976, it addresses what the learners need to know and be able to do in varying and complex situations, student and or workplace skills focused. When they developed competency-based curriculum in 1976, it was really for workplace, for the workplace. Yung mga test the courses sa atin, test the courses, para dun talaga yon. So it became very popular during the 1970s, and then they found out there were professions that said our profession is also skills based. The first group that said we are also skills based were the health professionals. So medicine became competency based, nursing became competency based, yung pang ibang health profession, dentistry and yung mga PT, they all became competency based. Okay. Please take note of that. Know and be able to do. Okay. And then that's competency based. Standards based. In 1991, then it resurfaced in 1995, SBE, it was introduced by Tucker. It sets academic standards for what students should know and be able to do. Standards are based on competencies, so we call them competency-based standards. Competency-based standards. What are the two phrases that are common with competency-based and standards-based? Know, be able to do. Okay. We are also standards-based, even in college, tertiary, because we have exams. We have tests. So we have to attain a certain level of standard. In tertiary level, I'm sure everybody passed the licensure exam for teachers. So we have to have a standard. So we are also standards-based, competency-based standards. And the last one, outcomes. Outcomes-based, OBE, was popularized by Spady. Actually, earlier, there were already outcomes. Outcomes were already being mentioned in the literature. I'm sure you're familiar with Gagne. Gagne already mentioned outcomes, but it was Spady who made it very popular. So tertiary level now, CHED has issued a policy, a CMO, CHED Memorandum Order, that all colleges and universities in the Philippines should be outcomes-based. And our task force was tasked to prepare an implementation guideline, implementation handbook on OBE. So what is OBE? It's a model of education that makes students demonstrate what they know, are able to do, or are like as a result of their education. So what are the common terms again? Know, be able to do, but Spady added another phrase. Or are like. This one, at the time of graduation. At the time of graduation, that is the outcome. That is the outcome. So what are we? Are we competency-based, standards-based, outcomes-based, all of the above? Are we? We are all of the above. Kasi pare-pareho naman siya eh. Pare-pareho lang halos. They target know, be able to do. But the CHED definition, I don't know if I have it here. No, I don't have it. Okay. CHED made its own definition for outcomes-based. They included, kasi or are like. Malinaw ba yung or are like? Is that very clear? Is that very clear, or are like? What is it? What do you think is or are like? At the time of graduation, the student should know, be able to do, and are like this. Okay, which domain of learning is missing? Is cognitive there? Which is cognitive? Is affective there? wala ang affective. Siguro yung or are like sa outcomes. Is psychomotor there? Yes, the skills. So what Chet did was they included the word value. Value. The student should be able to know, value, and ano isa? Be able to do. So we added the word value. Matutuwa ang ESP dyan. Okay. This is Tomlinson's figure. There is the content. Teachers can differentiate content, process, or the learning activities, product, or the performance indicator, and the environment according to students' readiness, interests, and learning profiles through a range of instructional and management strategies. For example, these are the examples: adjusting questions, interest centers, learning centers, graphic organizers, etc., etc. Okay, so that's the framework. This is the framework of DI adopted from Tomlinson. The spirit of differentiated teaching for learning. Can we read this, please? In teaching, yes, even if you use up all your saliva talking the whole day, if your students did not learn, then you really have not taught. You really have not taught. So this is the spirit of differentiated learning. Please remember that. Learner-centered. We're now going to learner-centered because this is the spirit of differentiated instruction. Is no longer teaching and learning, but learning and teaching, teaching for learning. This is something I stopped teaching when I retired from the University of the Philippines 10 years ago. So I don't teach at UE. But last year, Metrobank Foundation selected former winners of the outstanding teachers, and 10 of us were sent to Queensland University of Technology for 1 month to study curriculum and leadership. Kaya pag nag-Metrobank kayo, kahit na matanda na kayo, hawak pa rin kayo ng Metrobank, may ginagawa pa rin sa inyo. So, and when we were studying there, I said, oh, these are new things for me. These are new things because I have not taught since 2005 when I retired from UP. Kasi tayo, sanay na sanay, calling it teaching and learning, di ba? We always say teaching and learning. Ngayon, dapat learning and teaching to put more importance on the learning. Because of that adage, if the students have not learned, the teacher has not taught. Or teaching for learning. Remember always that when we teach, it is for the students to learn, not for us to deliver. Not for us to deliver. Kaya pag binigyan ko kayo ng test mamaya, assessment, pag binigyan ko kayo ng test at hindi nyo nakuha, ibig sabihin ako nagturo ng isang kalahating oras. Okay. So I'm already telling you, we have an assessment at the end. Wow, what's that murmur? Don't worry. Now I would like to share with you, this is another thing that I added because of Saul. Kahapon, nagdaldala na naman kami. Ang dami na naman niyang nabanggit na gusto niyang pa-background. Sabi ko, sige, meron akong pang-background dyan. I would like to tell you the story of Andy and Paddy. But for this, you have to help me. Saan ko kaya? You have to help me with this. So I will, how many groups do we have? Seven? Do we have seven? Sige, di bale. My, cannot. I'm sorry, I just had a surgical, an eye surgery the other week. I'm still on leave, so I cannot read very well. Okay, this group will be children. You have to help me tell the story. That group will be children. These two groups will be priests. Priests. Think of an action and something that you will say. This group will be kings. This group will be adults. And that group will be teachers. Okay. Think of an action and words that you will say when I call you. Sige. Children. Children, you will please stand. Please stand. Okay. Do an action and say some words. Children. Ready? Children. And what is your word or words? Anong ginagawa ninyo? Nag-uugoy-ugoy ba kayo? I will go back to you. Priests. 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 Dalawa kayong group. Okay? Ready? Go. Oy, isa lang. Ready? And? Sabay-sabay. Ayan. Ako, mukha na kayong banal. You look very holy. And kings. What is your word? Say something. Again? Nako. King of DepEd. Kingdom na pala DepEd. Ready. Adults. Adults. Wow. Wisdom. Sigurado kayo, ha? Teachers. Ano yun? Post? Okay. Alright. Sige. I will just... Can you see me? Can you see me? I will just use my fingers, ha? Number one will be children. Number one. Number two, priests. Number three, kings. Number four, adults. And number five, teachers. Okay. This is the story of Paddy and Andy. Pedagogy literally means the art and science of teaching children. Pedagogy started with early priests who wrote down common characteristics among children. Wait, tumayo kayo. Ako lang nakatayo rito. Okay. Learning, reading, writing, and counting. In the 7th century, the children... and church schools. Ala, natulog na yung pare. Oras na nga ba pagtulog ninyo? Again. Again. In the 7th century, I will leave you na. The church schools taught young priests to read and write so that they could later translate the holy books. And that is how pedagogy began. Through the Middle Ages, the priests taught children of kings how to rule and prepared other children to become priests. Amen. So, pedagogy is spread to the church schools in Europe and America. The art and science of teaching adults is called andragogy. The word andragogy was introduced in 1833 by a German high school teacher whose name was Alexander Kapp. During the middle of the 20th century, instructors realized that what they knew about children's learning did not apply to the adults they were teaching. Andragogy, therefore, came out in France, Yugoslavia, and Holland. Andragogy was used popularly in the study of adult education. It was introduced in the United States by Malcolm Knowles in the 1960s. And that is the story of pedagogy and andragogy. Thank you. The pronunciation is first accent of the first syllable, hindi pedagogy, hindi andragogy, pedagogy, andragogy. Okay. Okay. This is the meaning of the word. The term andragogy, the affix is under, the Greek meaning aner. The English translation is man or adult. The literal meaning is teaching adults, but the educational meaning is learner-directed or learner-centered instruction, helping adults learn. Learner-centered instruction. And we are not doing it only for adults. We're also doing it for our children and our students, pupils and students. Pedagogy. Pedagogy, ped, the affix, hey, the Greek word is ped. English translation is child. Teaching children is the literal translation, but the educational meaning is teacher-directed instruction. Teacher-directed instruction. So we are more concerned with the educational meaning of pedagogy and andragogy. And Gogi or agogos, the Greek term, it means leading. So leading children or teaching children and teaching adults. And that's the reason why, what do we call the doctor for children? Pediatrics, ped also. And the medical practice is called pediatrics. So pedion, it comes from that. It comes from a Greek word. Okay, you don't need to copy this because DepEd has prepared, actually DepEd, Saul gave me a copy of the learning plan for this session. I just made some changes, but it will be very helpful to you because background information and the abstraction is there. You will be given that. Oh. Can you see it very well? Hindi masyado, no? Pero it will be in the CD. Okay. This is called the experience cone. When we were studying in the undergrad, we learned about Dale's cone of experience. Do you remember that in the 1950s? Ay, hindi pa kayo napanganak noon, ano? Sorry, nasa college na ako noon. Half of this cone is teacher-directed, the other half is learner-centered. Okay, where is teacher-directed? From where? It means, okay, from where? From which part? Which is teacher-centered? Up or down? Which is teacher-centered? The one up or down? You cannot read very well. This is reading. When the teacher says, read tomorrow, read chapter 1, and we are going to discuss it. That's reading. This is listening, is the lecturing of the teacher, teacher talk. Looking at charts and diagrams is no talk. Flat pictures, looking at flat pictures, even PowerPoint presentation, just by looking at this, that's a flat picture. So looking at charts, diagrams, watching a film and or a video. So there's already talking and seeing. And then this one is, cannot see. Watching a demonstration, the teacher is demonstrating, the students are watching. Participating in a discussion, group discussion, or class discussion. Making a presentation, the students present. Participating in a role play or dramatization, the students do this. Simulating or practicing the real thing. If you cannot do the real thing, you simulate. And the last one is doing the real thing. Okay, so which is teacher directed? Up or down? Until where? Until watching a demonstration. Until here. This is teacher directed. And therefore, this one is learner-centered. And this has something to do with what we tend to remember. This is based on research, and UNESCO also did a research on this, what we tend to remember. This was taken from SHIELD 1989, training. If you ask them to read only, they will remember only 10% of what they read. Because they are only verbally receiving the printed word. 20% of what they hear. So if you talk to the class the whole day, they will remember only 20%. Pag nag-lecture kayo, 20% lang matatanda nila. They are verbally receiving, still verbally receiving. Pwede na lang kung yung teacher ay visual aid din at maarte, siguro madadagdag yung 20% na yan. Looking at charts and PowerPoint presentation, ilang percent yan? 30% of what they see. Seeing now is included. They are now visually receiving. Watching a film or video, 50% because there's already listening. Teaching demonstration, still 30%. 70, if the students are the one discussing, 90% here. What is the usefulness of this? If you are going to choose learning activities, you start from below. Dito ka mag-umpisa. Can the students do it? Yes, do that. The students cannot do it, so go up. Can they simulate? Can I simulate the lesson? Hindi pa rin pwede. Akyat, can they do group discussion for the lesson to come out? So this is the last recourse. It teaches you how to choose. Learn teaching strategies, learning activities. Now, the reading. Can we do away with reading? No, because you have your learning guide, you have your learning materials for students, right? Okay, what can you do? What can you add to the reading to make it higher? Not only 10%. What can you add to the reading here? Can you add something to the reading to make it higher, 10%, more than 10%.
Perhaps we can tell them to do a role play on what they read, about what they read.
That's wonderful. And role play is an ano to? 70%. So you have added something to your reading. You have made it higher. You have made it higher. Now, your teacher talk, your lecture, what can you add to your lecture to make it more learner-centered? We cannot do away with the teacher talk. So what can you add to make it learner-centered? Here.
Good morning, ma'am. Possible, the teacher should assign a group, a small group work to, she or he will give some worksheets or activity sheets for them to work with in order for the teacher to listen his work, make herself as a facilitator of the students.
Okay, thank you. But activity sheet entails reading. I hope the activity sheet also has other learning activities that are more active than reading. Okay. In college, in our university, we made an agreement with the faculty members about the percentage of teacher talk. When I arrived there first in 2009, it was mostly lecture. Alam naman ninyo, sa college, silig mag-lecture ng mga teachers. Kala nila sila lang talaga yung marunong. Anyway, so we agreed on a 60-40. 60% teacher talk, 40% students, student activity. And then after 2 years, we have made it 70% student activity, 30% teacher talk. It's very difficult to shift gears. To shift gears, especially if the teacher is so used to talking. Kaya maraming teacher nagkaka-cancer sa lalamunan eh. Dahil sa magaling tayong dumaldal. Magaling tayong dumaldal. Okay. So I will leave that. But that is a guide that we can use. Remember, can you please read it? Remember, at the same time, please. Even faster. Yan yung telling, that's the lecturing of the teacher. Okay. This is the last activity, I think. The last activity. Wow. Divide, you're seven, no? Into seven areas, subgroups, according to the learning. Divide your subgroup into seven. Some of you will have two in a subgroup, two or three. For example, 3, 6, 9, 12, 13, 15, 18. You are 18 divided by 7. Divide into, so 7, 14. Some of you will be 2 working as pairs. Others will be working as trios. Okay? So can you do that, please? Divide your subgroup, your learning area, into 7. Team leader, please divide your learning areas. Oh, yung magkakatabi. Thank you. Okay. Ready? You will assign, or they can choose which one they like. One will work on content. Sorry. One will work on content. One will work on process or learning activities. One will work on products or assessments, performance indicators. One will work on environment. Apat pa lang yan. Can you assign those already or choose? Choose? There are four. Four pa lang yan. There are still three coming. Have you chosen? Okay. According to learner characteristics, readiness, one another will work on readiness, interest, learning profile. Sorry, I missed one, environment. Number 4 is environment. Ah, nasa preceding. Ayun. So, there are 7. 7 of you, 7 subgrouping will work on one each. And this one is learning profiles or learning styles, multiple intelligences, etc. Just choose one per subgroup. Team leader, have you finished assigning or tapos na? Alam na? Oh, sige. Oops. How many who are working on content? May I see the hands? Who are working on content? May I see the hands? All right, content. Who are working on process or learning activities? May I see? Learning activities. Here. Learning activities. Who are working on products or assessment? Assessment. Okay, good. Assessment here. Meron na pong assignment. Do you have assignments already? Assessment, meron na. Okay, assessment. Environment. Environment? Yes. Do you have already? And learner's readiness. Learner's interest. Okay. Learning profiles. Let's get. This is what you will do. No, I will give you ideas first about each. I will give you ideas. When we talk of environment, who is doing environment? Okay. Do environment? Environment. Who is assigned environment here? Sino environment? Okay. Sige. Thank you. When we say environment, we are talking of psychological environment and physical setting. Psychological, yung sa class, climate in the classroom, the what is happening in the classroom. Physical, time, noise, space, the use of space. This is more of classroom management. Environment, the way of teaching. This is a quotation by Jose Rizal. Can we read it, please? He Socrates taught in the public street, Plato in the gardens of the academy, even Christ among the mountains and lakes. This is a quotation by Rizal referring to place, environment, the where of teaching. Now, this one is about interest. McCann and Erickson is a company in Makati. They did 2 studies about Filipino youth. One was done in 2000, the other one was done in 2005. It's a nationwide study with 2,000 Filipino youth as respondents. And they found out, the 2005 study showed that the primary interest of our youth is technology-related activities after school. Can you relate with this? Ganyan ba ang mga bata ninyo sa high school? Sa inyo? Because in 2000, they found out that the primary interest of youth was watching television. Nung year 2000, television sila. Nung 2005, hindi na TV. Ayan na. And what are they doing? Ayan. Use of cell phones and the internet. Less TV, but more of online chatting, texting, internet gaming, and surfing usage. Remember this interest of the youth, because for those who are doing interest, put this in your mind so that you can think about this while you are doing the task that you will do. Readiness, okay, readiness. Responding to learners' readiness, what will you do with students who are not quite ready? Those who are ready, those who are more than ready, these are examples, these two are examples of activities, differentiated activities that they can do. Reteaching or remediation requires more depth, oh sorry, this is their characteristic. Requires more depth and competence and complexity into of concepts. Okay, those are the characteristics for readiness. Now you're going to have a workshop and you're going to do a presentation afterwards about your assignment. How will you differentiate content? How will you differentiate activities? Differentiate assessment? How will you cater to learners' needs? What differentiation will you do for the environment, for learners' needs, for readiness, and for profile? Okay? Can I give you... It's 2 o'clock. It's 12. Can I give... We started at 11. Actually, we started at 11:20 already. Can I give you just 10 minutes for that? Maski two or three. Two or three ways of differentiating. Sige. You're going to present to your group. You're going to present, share with your group what you did, the differentiation that you are going to do for each aspect. Okay, can I give you, because you had only approximately 7 minutes, 1 minute per area. 7 minutes for the sharing. Please stand. The one who will share, stand in the middle of your group so that you can be heard. Thank you. Time's up. Hindi pa tapos. There are already groups that are through. Can we leave that now? Can we leave it? At least you have an idea. In the handout that DepEd will give you, which is the session plan, you will see there different ways of differentiating these 7 aspects. Differentiating the 7 aspects. Sample ways of doing the differentiation. Okay, can we continue now? Excuse me, can we continue? Okay. This is the learner profile. I'm doing a wrap up now. What kind of a learner are you? I'm going to project 4 types of learners that Honey and Mumford discovered when they did the research and they used a questionnaire. I cannot give you the questionnaire because that's 80 items and we will not be able to do it here. So, ano na lang, what do you think? What kind of a learner are you? If you will identify with the description, please stand. If you identify with the description, please stand. Sometimes, there are people who identify with more than one. It's okay, you can stand as many times as you want. Okay, the first one. These are the concrete experiencers, or we call them activists. In short, they are activists. They have receptive, experience-based approach to learning. They rely heavily on feeling-based judgments. They learn best from specific examples, involvement, and discussions. Who thinks they are activists? How many of you think you are activists? Please stand. Okay. Who are the activists in the group? All right. So these are our activists. Thank you. Next. These are the reflective observers. We call them reflectors. Parang ilaw ng kotse, no? Reflectors. They like to watch and listen. They are reserved and quiet. They take their time before acting or participating. They have tentative, impartial, and reflective approach. They rely on careful observations. Who are the reflectors? Wow, there are more reflectors than activists. Pero mukhang hindi naman kayo quiet. All right. The third. Sorry. These are the theorists. They are abstract conceptualizers, or in short, the theorists. They have an analytical approach. They use logical thinking and rational evaluation. They learn best from impersonal situations, opportunity to integrate, that's a very important word, integrate new learning with what is already known, and they learn best from theory. Oh, who are the theorists in this group? Stand, please, the theorists. No one? There's no theorist here, ah? Pero kanina meron isa, all right? One, we have only one. Anybody else? All right, two. The last, the pragmatists, or the active experiencers. They are pragmatic. They say, yes, but will it work? Mahilig sila sa ganon. They rely heavily on experimentation. They learn best from projects, back home applications, trying it out. Now that I know all this, what am I going to do with it? Now that I know all of this, what am I going to do with it? With this, that's the thinking of the pragmatist. Who are the pragmatists here? Mahilig sila sa applying. Who are the pragmatists? Okay, all right. So you are the pragmatists. Sige. Thank you. Oh my golly. Hindi nakikita. This is... Sorry. This is the experiential learning cycle. Ayun. Okay. These are the activists, the reflectors, the theorists, and the pragmatists. And it was translated into an instructional design. The learning profile was translated into an instructional design. Okay. The activists, activity. They're good in activity. The reflective, That's the analysis. The theorists are good in abstraction. And the pragmatists are good in application. Do you see the four A's? That is your four A's. That's the basis. That's the theoretical basis of your four A's. Of your four A's. So, it's nice because everyone will be able to contribute. Everyone will be able to contribute. When I taught four A's in my undergraduate class at UP, I added one more A because we were applying it to the classroom, instructional design. So I added another A. We called it 5A. That is the last A, assessment. We included assessment because after applying, we want to finish it with assessment because it's applied in the classroom. That is your four A's. Flashback. Going back, we are now reviewing. My activity. We started with activity. Yan yung true or false. Ano yung susunod na step? The next A? Analysis. What was my analysis? What did we do with the true or false? The analysis... I have no more time to do, but this is the what, the activity. The analysis is the why. Diba? What was my question to you after the activity? True or false? And then? Why is your answer true? That or false? That is the analysis. Justify your answer. What's the third one? Abstraction. What did we do after why? What did you learn? I told you to connect the two, di ba? Connect this with this and make a sentence about it. That's the abstraction. Remember, you gave very, very good sentences. They are already principles and concepts. So, from the what, the why, you combine the what and the why, you come up with the what did you learn. And who contributed what they learned? Combining the two. From each table, nakalimutan nyo na? Sino? Okay, si ma'am there. Who else contributed what did you learn? You combined the two statements. And then you were able to create abstraction. Abstraction is not only lecture of the teacher. You start with the students. If there are things that are not mentioned by the students, that's the time you will lecture. That's the time you will lecture. It has to come from the students. And what? So, ayan, sorry. What did you learn about DI? Then my lecture. I lectured to you. And the last part is application. What you just did now. Application, your group work. How are you going to apply what you learned? Ito yon. How will you apply? This is the how. This is the how. Your last group work. Your last group work. So you see the learning cycle? You see the learning cycle? Okay. That's the flashback. Oops. Anyway, the last part is the assessment. So after application, we have assessment. Are you ready for the assessment? Oh, sige, you are ready. Like the first one, true or false, you're going to do an action. An action, okay. Raise your fingers like this, raise your fingers. Fold the middle finger. Fold the middle finger like this. Put together, join the two middle fingers, the knuckles of the two middle fingers. The knuckles of the two middle fingers. But ayaw niya to.
Let the two knuckles touch, the two knuckles of your finger, middle finger touch, and then close the others. Hold, let the tips of the fingers touch. Please be sure that the knuckles of your middle finger are touching. Okay. First objective in performance indicator. Can you now discuss the basic principles of differentiated instruction? That was our activity, the what and the why. The basic principles of differentiated instruction. If your answer is yes, move your thumbs together like that. If your answer is yes, move your thumbs, your two thumbs. Team leader, can you please look at your group if they are... If they are moving their thumb, if they are not moving their thumb, it means they have not attained this. Okay? Next. Meron bang hindi naka-attain? Number two. Oo nga, thank you. Number two. Can you now identify activities suited to its component of DI? Content, process, product, environment. Can you now identify activities? Move your little finger for yes. Move. Team leader, please look at your group mates if they have attained this. Okay. Number three, can you identify activities that respond to learners' needs? Readiness, interest, learning profile. If your answer is yes, move your pointer. Team leaders, please see if they are moving their pointer for yes and not for no. And the last question, are you ready for lunch? Move your ring finger. Team leader, can you see? Can you see? Aha, they are not moving. So we will continue the lecture. Thank you.
This is not actually a question, ma'am, but a clarification on one of the test items which we answered false. True. We answered true, but everyone, you answered false. This is on individualization. On the other hand, we understood that the concept of individualization is to treat individual pupils in isolation from the rest. But our point of discussion on individualization is that each pupil in the classroom is unique. And so each one deserves a unique, a unique approach or strategy in learning. That's why we consider that individualization. So each one needs an individualized activity, individualized instruction. That's why we answered true for that question.
Thank you. You have a point there. However, we have to be realistic. We are teaching a class. We are not tutoring. We are not tutoring individual students. We are teaching a class. Even in remediation, you put a group together. Those who have the same abilities, you put them together. Otherwise, you have no time to do individualization. With students who number 50 in a classroom, you cluster them. You cluster them and do differentiated instruction. Eh, baka maaga tayong matimbuang pagkain isa-isa natin yung 50 na yon. But that's ideal. That's ideal, but it's not practical. It's not realistic in our classroom. Thank you for that.
Okay, I hope that's understood, sir. Okay, last one. If you have other questions, if there are other individuals who still would like to go and ask questions, you may write them down so that we could be able to go and maybe entertain those things later on. Final questions? One final question? Ah, wala na.
I thought you don't want to eat yet. Kala ko ayaw niyo pang kumain.
Let's make it a little bit more thunderous to show how hungry we are.